Opendoor is represented by Opendoor Brokerage Inc. License number
6110
in California and Opendoor Brokerage LLC in the Southern Market. Get your free offers today at opendoor.com/KFI. Return your Honda lease to one of our five Honda lease return super centers, or swap your old ride for a brand new Honda. And with more vehicles arriving for the holidays, you'll get a super selection and a super experience. Every new Normreach Honda is backed by our exclusive price protection guarantee, which states if you can find the same new Honda for less within 5 days, Normreach will pay you the difference or buy your vehicle back. Discover the joy of the season and Superstore during Happy Honda Day. Visit our super award-winning Normreach Honda Superstore location in Huntington Beach, and the number one Honda store in the world in the Cerritos Auto Square, Los Reno, Open Vista. Shop online at normreach.com.
Blew out your way through this holiday season with the LA Kings Holiday Pass. Each pass includes one ticket to 3 or 5 LA Kings home games, plus a limited edition Drew Doughty Tropical Mug. To purchase, visit lakings.com/holidaypass.
Friends, family, out-of-town guests, you've got a lot to celebrate this month, but that's also a lot of meals to prepare. Times like these, you want Sizzler. Tender hand-cut steaks, plump, juicy lobster, or that world-famous salad bar means there's something for everybody to celebrate. Whether you're looking for a quick and easy solution for the big day, or a great place to gather the other 30 nights of December, we're here, we're open, and best of all, we're delicious. For the nearest Sizzler restaurant, go to locations.sizzler.com.
Living with someone who tested positive for COVID-19 in the past 5 days, those 18 and over who are not vaccinated may be able to take part in a clinical trial for a possible medication to prevent COVID-19. Participants will receive study-related care at no cost. To learn more, visit COVIDMoveAhead.com.
Sponsored by Merck. Looking for a good investment? Want to reduce uncertainty, financial risk, and hedge inflation? Here are 8 reasons to consider NRIA's Prime Real Estate Development Fund. Steady monthly cash flow payouts with double-digit targeted returns. Solid, affordable, high-demand home and apartment assets back you. New construction built where housing is badly needed and demand deemed. Substantial properties already built and selling right now supporting you. Short and long-term strategies with steady cash flow and appreciation anticipated. An industry leader with a 15-year track record of 3 million square feet built and a pipeline of $1.7 billion of new property in progress. Hedge against inflation and receive steady cash flow. Start your due diligence at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Lead encouraged. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
People are defective and unfixable. You think arson would be a pretty big deal? They don't consider that a serious or violent crime.
Why people get upset if we have a lot of people in jail?
They think that that's a terrible life and a waste.
Well, they are a waste.
John and Ken.
We did it too.
You want to help them?
What?
On KFI.
Friday morning, December 17th, Wright Brothers Day and Ugly Christmas Sweater Day. So, does that mean the Wright Brothers are known for wearing ugly Christmas sweaters? You know, that one I don't know. That bit of trivia I do know.
It's also Shirt Day, so does that mean that they always feast it on pancakes after their textbook?
Possibly. That's a good point. Let's go ahead and finish Handle on the News with Jennifer Wayne.
A former student at Villa Park High School has been charged with hacking into a Google Classroom account and posting racist and homophobic photos and comments for all the students and teachers to see. Erin Petalar, 19 now, of Orange, a felony account of unauthorized computer access and a felony hate crime enhancement, according to who? It's Orange County. Who?
Todd Spitzer.
You're finding it.
Yes, Todd, yeah.
All right, they have issued now a search warrant for Alec Baldwin's phone in connection with the fatal shooting on the set of Rush. I love in this story from KTLA how it's written the low-budget Western movie Rush.
So this was an 8-page warrant that included Alec Baldwin's phone because they want to see the text messages that went on that day. They want to see what was downloaded, what information was there. Did he make calls? Did he make emails? What did he do?
You know, texting, I mean, if you talk about all the texts that you send out during the day, I mean, I'm sure there's some that he sent out to, you know, some women who know, you know, hey, baby, what are you wearing right now kind of text. I'm assuming those, who looked at them, and what did the investigators say? Hey, look at this.
The legal department and Alcohol Media would like me to point out, A, there's no evidence Alec Baldwin sent any sex.
That is correct.
And also, those would not be relevant to this investigation.
That is correct. That was going to be my next point after you so rudely interrupted me and stopped my plan.
He's got enough on his plate like that. Now, on the other hand, remember in this Sex and the City reboot, and the character of Mr. Big rides on a Peloton and then has a heart attack and dies. So when Peloton wanted to counter the negative effect on their stock and reputation from this by doing an ad with the actor, Chris Noss, where he talks about how Peloton's great for your health, which it is. Although riding any bike, you don't have to have a $2,500 bike for your health. But anyway, now that ad has been pulled because the Hollywood Reporter published a story about sexual assault allegations against Chris Noss. You have to vet. How do you vet anybody anymore in order to do business with them?
And how quickly can you destroy a career with an allegation, which later on there's no evidence corroborating it, or it turns out to be true, or the person recants is making the allegation? I mean, today it's no longer provable or to be proved. It's now just straight, he did this to me.
He says they are categorically false. No, he said, no, all these things, no, this is a line I did not cross. The encounters were consensual.
Which is always
so true. I guess he's admitting he did have a perspective.
Yeah, but again,
people, and now they're saying it wasn't consensual. Yeah. He's saying it was.
And going back to what Candle was saying, when it comes to the business side of things, I think that commercial, the Peloton commercial, was hugely successful after that episode. But the thing is, if you're a business and you employ somebody who then afterwards gets accused of something like this, isn't that person innocent until proven guilty? So do you run the risk of either society says you better get this guy off because, you know, get him off of your commercial, or do you have to stand by it and say, all we know about this guy is
they don't do that anymore. No, they used to be that case. They don't. One more and then we're out of here.
All right. So Melania Trump is releasing her own NFT. So you know those non-fungible tokens. And she said it'll include watercolor art that embodies Mrs. Trump's cobalt eyes, providing the collector with an amulet to inspire, according to the statement. It's currently priced at $187, which is one soul.
Soul, a cryptocurrency on the Solana blockchain. Then one soul.
Sounds like
one actual soul. No, it actually will cost you an actual soul to get this thing. Yeah, that's great. Where do they get that?
It doesn't have to be your own. If you can get somebody else to give up their soul, you can have this.
That comes from a Star Trek adventure, the soul. You know that. That's where they pull. Yeah, think about that. All right. Look at you.
Did she paint this herself?
I don't think so.
I don't painted it of her, but she approves.
I think that she approves of it. Because nowhere in here does it say that she's an artist and is a painter.
It's a very low get into the NFT game. Yeah, but look at everybody else who's getting these major stars. Justin Bieber, BTS. Mm-hmm. You can buy one for one jar of kimchi. Lindsay Lohan.
It's time to go.
Oh, okay.
I need to do this.
You know what? You are so full of bull goggy.
On that sweater he's wearing?
We're done. Coming up. So how do you go to college? Junior college. Not go to junior college. Get a financial aid. And it's not even you. I'll tell you that story, although it is you. I always play it. This is at KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
The holidays. Look at all the beautiful lights. Permanent traffic.
KFI.
KOST 82.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Tagging up. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. LA County has tightened its COVID-19 restrictions. The new rules cover indoor events with more than 1,000 people and outdoor events with more than 10,000 people. Unvaccinated people must provide proof of a negative antigen COVID test taken within 1 day or within 2 days if you get a PCR test. An oil seen off the coast of Bolsa Chica State Beach is estimated to be significantly smaller than a recent 25,000-gallon spill.
Huntington Beach Mayor Barbara Del Glaze says so far a calm ocean has helped keep the football field size seen away from the shore.
Last time, the tides and the wind moved it down the shoreline so quickly. I mean, we were reporting in Huntington, and they already hit it in Newport.
Huntington Beach Police spokeswoman Jennifer Carey says crews learned from the spill in October.
So the boom broke, which was ultimately what led to the oil coming into this protected space the first time around.
Now a berm protects the wetland area. Carey says the scene first reported Wednesday is in the same general area as the earlier spill at Bolsa Chica Beach. Corbin Carson, KFI News.
LA County Supervisor Catherine Barger has given some of her discretionary funds to the Sheriff's Department.
Barger says her $1 million gift is for things like overtime and other patrol expenses.
There's no question in my mind that trying to bring public safety to an adequate level that's going to protect the community.
Barger says the department can use the funds how it sees fit. The money will help 8 stations in her district, which covers 70 communities. Barger says she also supports properly funding the Sheriff's Department by allowing more academy classes.
Three men in Garden Grove have been arrested for allegedly using sleight of hand to swipe jewelry off mostly elderly Asian people in 28 robberies. Police Sergeant Evan Beresford says the robberies would happen while the person was wearing the jewelry.
They're so smooth and methodical in their approach, they can lay a necklace on their victim, and as they're putting it on, they're able to unclasp and remove it without the victim knowing sometimes.
Beresford says the thieves would sometimes swap a watch or necklace for a fake one or to snatch the jewelry off if all else fails. He says the three Romanians are intentionally transient, so the scheme can move from state to state. U.S. Congressman Jimmy Gomez, who represents Chinatown, says he'll probably call for an investigation into a low-income senior building there.
Gomez says he has concerns about federal money that went to the management company that owns Cathay Manor being misused. He says not only is the building in poor condition, but the people living there say they haven't asked to pay for their own basic repairs.
It's despicable that I hear that they're being charged for basic repairs when in the HUD contract itself, they're not supposed to be charged. That's what the money is for.
Gomez is calling on the CEO of the company that owns the building to step down. The city filed criminal charges against the company that owns the building and its CEO in October over elevators being broken. Well, Trolley, KFI News.
President Biden's Build Back Better agenda has stalled in the Senate.
Democrats were hoping to get this done before the holiday, but the president admitting that is just not likely going to happen. He says he failed to reach a deal with Senator Joe Manchin, the critical Democrat from West Virginia.
ABC's Mary Bruce says Manchin is against the bill's $2 trillion price tag and against expansion of the administration's monthly child tax credit. The FDA has permanently loosened some restrictions on abortion pills. The change means prescriptions can be filled online and by mail. And more than 100 Marines have been discharged for refusing to get the COVID-19 vaccine. The deadline for active duty Marines to be vaccinated was November 28th. The Air Force also started discharging service members this week. There are about 30,000 active duty military personnel who haven't met the federal vaccine requirements. We got you right on the 210.
We sure do. As a matter of fact, as I speak to you right now, we're flying west over the 210, coming up over beautiful San Anita Racetrack. And is there any? Yeah, they're running around there. All right, your drive is pretty good, really. It's a little slow coming away from the 57. That's kind of a given every morning. But from the 605 into Pasadena, I think you'll be okay. Even the southbound 605 leaving the 210, remarkably good. It's a little slow at Washington now. Here it comes. That's a big problem. We're kind of in between both of these, but we'll go to the San Fernando Valley first. We spent a lot of time there. Westbound 101 before Topanga, only left lane open. Parking lot through Tampa, any surface street, get on the westbound run, to Bank 10, you'll be okay. And if you're eastbound, you're going to get off at the Shore Boulevard, Bank 10, there's a crash on the off-ramp, and Cerritos, all traffic from Vegas, parking lot 2 to 605, get on Corbinita, and don't go away. A lot more updates coming up. Injured in an accident, this is Superwoman, superlawyer.com, Jeff Fong, AFI in the sky.
The Chargers fell to the Kansas City Chiefs at SoFi Stadium by a score of 34-28 in overtime. Both quarterback Justin Herbert regrets not converting more downs.
It's always tough, and you'd love to be able to convert those. And I think we need to be better on third downs. We're not in those situations, but we believe in each other. We believe in the guys in that locker room, in that huddle, and we believe in the defense. You know, unfortunately, we didn't convert as many as we would have liked to have today, but we're going to ride with each other, and we're going to be right back.
Some basketball for you today. The Lakers are at the Minnesota Timberwolves at 7. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports. You need a good night's sleep. I mean, it's that simple. The difference between getting a good night's sleep and dealing with the next day and not getting a good night's sleep and not really dealing with the next day very well, that's important. And let me tell you about the Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. It's about getting a good night's sleep. It's designed to make a difference in your life, and it does. I've been 14 years now sleeping on a Sleep Number bed. You can adjust, customize each side of the bed to your firmness level, the one you want at any time. That's your sleep number, that firmness level, and mine happens to be 100. I like a 6 week firm mattress. And now the Sleep Number weekend special, to save 50% on the Sleep Number 360 smart bed, plus special financing, that ends next Monday, and you'll only find Sleep Number stores here in Southern California. There are 30 of them if you live here. Or you can go to sleepnumber.com. Either way, you can buy the bed. Subject to credit approval, minimum monthly payments required. Go to sleepnumber.com for details. 30 locations in Southern California. Sleep Number, the official sleep and wellness partners of the Los Angeles Rams. sleepnumber.com. Spectrum Mobile is reinventing wireless again. Get unlimited on 2 plus lines for $29.99 a month per line. No contracts, no added taxes or fees. Includes nationwide 5G. Save up to 60% with Spectrum Mobile. Get unlimited on 2 plus lines for $29.99 a month. Call 855-438-2999 or visit a store near you.
Offer valid for new customers on 2 plus unlimited lines. Spectrum Internet required. Savings based on 2 lines comparison of unlimited plans among major national carriers as of 9/2021. Prepaid excluded. Restrictions apply.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is down 504. S&P is down 52. NASDAQ is down 118. And the average price of a gallon of unleaded gas in California is $4.67.
Bay Alarm security systems can change with your business, so you're right for now and ready for the next.
SoCal weather from KFI, sunny with highs mid-60s for today, tomorrow. Some clouds will start to roll in on Sunday into Monday with our next chance at rain coming Tuesday through Thursday. Right now it's 45 in Laguna Beach, 43 in Baldwin Park, 38 in Santa Clarita. The Lead Local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
AM 640, Bill Handel here on a Friday morning, December 17th. Coming up at, it's going to be a big day with a lot of good guests. Kelly Conway, Tim Conway Jr.'s sister, wrote a book about her dad. We're going to have her here. Foodie Friday is coming up, food influencers and the top recipes of 2021. And Steve Gregory is here at 8 o'clock talking about this weekend's episode of Unsolved with Steve Gregory. So I want to talk about, introduce you to a lady by the name of Kim Rich. She's a criminal justice professor at Pierce College here in the San Fernando Valley, over on the west part of it. And she has taken upon herself to become a bot sleuth, and here's why. You've got these hackers, if you will, these bot creators, who are applying for aid from their junior college, which they are students, or not, because they're actually not. She thinks that these bots are multiplying, and she and other faculty members have just grown frustrated at this investigation because Pierce College officials won't talk about it, and everybody is being really quiet except for her and other professors. The chancellor estimated that 20% of the recent traffic on the main portal were for online applications and were malicious and bot-related, and were all about financial aid fraud. So more than 50,000 suspected fake students applied for financial aid, and that's according to California Student Aid Commission. And at least of dollars they were able to track, and they're tracking more, in financial aid has been distributed to the bots. And the scope is unclear, and the state, in response, has asked each college to prepare monthly reports on the number of incidents and suspected and confirmed fraud registration, how many number of incidents of financial aid fraud, the dollar value, and we'll be using a new software to figure all of this out.